into the ring. There in the way is that huge man from Queens, New York, the Dingo Warrior. And Rick Cassidy doesn't want anything to start. There he is. That is one of the most awesome physical specimens I've ever seen. 285 or 90 pounds and just a mass of muscle. That kind of gives you even as large and as strong and as talented as gentleman Chris Adams is, you got to look at all that and say, good gracious, I got to fight through that. All right, let's go down to Mark Lawrence for the introduction of this astounding bout.
Our next bout, ladies and gentlemen, has a 20-minute time limit. Features first in the white tights from Queens, New York, 287 pounds, the Dingo Warrior. His opponent in this match is the defending world heavyweight champion, 238 pounds from England, gentleman Chris Adams. Rick Hazard, your referee.
So, gentleman Chris Adams will certainly have a task on hand. As I recall, and as you probably recall also, no one has been able to take Dingo off his feet. I'm just trying to avoid the strength of that man and then trying to put him down. But if anybody can do it, here's a man who can. He has the super kick. He has the gymnastic ability to throw the Dingo Warrior off his balance. So we should see something here. The Dingo Warrior. Lucky he was put together by U.S. Steel. So the mask is in tune with his shoes and his trunks.
Hey, Adams!
Oh, here's Percy Pringle.
You make me sick, boy! How in the world can you walk in this ring and hold your head up high and call yourself the world champion? You ain't champion or nothing! You didn't win the belt, boy! It's time for a rematch! I've talked to world class. It's time for a rematch, Adams! Can't you hear? It's time for a rematch! You ain't nothing but a stinking, limey coward is what you are! A stinking, limey coward!
Oh, there's a hit with a microphone, a shove with a cane, and Chris Adams is at a disadvantage.
It's time for a rematch!
And Percival Pringle, the third, in just using that insulting terms of a limey coward, he might have the whole British fleet on him. So that certainly gives the Dingo Warrior an opportunity to kind of, oh my goodness, look at this. What did I tell you about Dingo? Here's 245 pounds straight up in the air on top of the rope.
I told you ain't the circus with the rest of the elephants.
Chris Adams. Had a distinct disadvantage after that attack by Percival Pringle with the microphone, with the cane, and the Dingo Warrior, who liked to ride the subways in New York just to be tested. I don't know anybody who tests that guy unless he was wearing a shawl. Chris Adams held up by his throat, and Hazard counting him. I'm not sure Dingo can understand a count. And that's a choke. And Hazard may have to eliminate the Warrior here if he doesn't release Chris Adams. Or Chris may be eliminated himself by that chokehold. And tremendous strength exerted by Rick Hazard. Now Rick says, no, it is not a choke. It's up underneath the chin, so it is not a chokehold. At least Chris is not turning blue. The Dingo Warrior. A dingo, by the way, in Australia, is a little dog. Not just a little puppy dog, but a wild, wild, mean dog. That sucker is really mean. I'm not sure about what this sucker pretty mean. Chris Adams trying to come back right now. There's a super kick, and Dingo is down for the first time and out of the ring. The super kick. Like a right hand from Rocky Marciano in his great day. And I said, the Dingo Warrior, I wonder, maybe just pick the whole ring up and turn it over. Well, Chris Adams recovering from all the effects of the preliminary encounter in the bout. And the Dingo wrapped back by Chris Adams. Now, the Dingo Warrior has all that strength and all those muscles. But when it really gets down to it, there is a style and a degree of expertise as that super kick lands that Chris Adams has that is an equalizer. And he's going to go. Got to try to pick him up. He does. Chris has him straight up and back and down. The pile driver by Chris Adams. And I'm sure that the Dingo Warrior must wonder what in the world has hit him. Because here he had been invincible. Nobody been able to stand up to his strength. Chris Adams got off to a bad start. And the world champion has proven his tremendous ability, his tremendous talent, as he comes flying over. But look, the Dingo Warrior with his great strength turned that around. And on top the rope, flinging himself out, is Chris Adams on top. One, two, and three. And Chris Adams, did he get out? No, he didn't. Chris Adams, beaten by the Dingo Warrior. And a tremendous upset as this awesome creature from the Queens, New York, has defeated the world heavyweight champion. Of course, there was the Percy Pringle opening situation. And now let's go down to Mark Lorenz.
The winner of this match, the Dingo Warrior.
Chris Adams is a furious young man, and you can understand why. And he has taken the choke. He's taken the run on the top rope. And it is embarrassing for a champion to be beaten.